Hello and welcome to this presentation. My name is Fabian Eisele. I'm a senior product management engineer at Vector, and I'm responsible for Microsoft Charge and Microsoft TSN. The topics I want to present today are first to give an overview over Microsoft Charge, then to look at which features are introduced with the new Microsoft 4 release 27, and at the end, give a quick outlook on new feature additions that you can expect soon. So let's start with the overview on Microsoft Charge. To be more specific, Microsoft Charge for CCS. Prior to Microsoft 4 release 27, we have already fully supported DC charging according to DIN spec 70121, as well as AC and DC charging according to ISO 15108-2 and 3. All mentioned standards are fully implemented, meaning all defined features such as plug and charge or certificate installation are supported by Microsoft Charge. There are many benefits to using Microsoft Charge. It's easy to use since the application only needs to interface with one module, VSCC. To reduce the complexity and resource consumption as much as possible, Microsoft Charge is highly configurable. Any unnecessary features may simply be disabled. This means that certain APIs, along with their source code and memory buffers, are removed. Sensitive data, such as private keys, may be securely stored in the HSM by utilizing the CSM. Additionally, Microsoft Charge fulfills all conformance tests defined for DIN spec 70121 and ISO 15108. This includes DIN spec 70122 as well as ISO 15108-4 and 5. Please note that these conformance tests are defined on a system level, meaning the configuration of our software as well as the application play a part in them. Now I want to focus your attention to the figure on the right side. You can see Microsoft Charge in conjunction with its main dependencies, Microsoft Ethernet and Microsoft Crypto. Before Microsoft 4 release 27, Microsoft Charge was using the vTLS module to establish a TLS connection and the NVM to store certificates. As mentioned, private keys were already securely stored in the VHSM using the CSM. As you will see on the next slide, this architecture has changed with Microsoft 4 release 27. All right, let's take a look at what's new with Microsoft 4 release 27. The new major feature is the support of ISO 15118-20. We now support AC and DC charging with EIM, the bidirectional power transfer, as well as the scheduled and dynamic control mode. More to the bidirectional power transfer and the dynamic mode on the next slide. As mentioned on the last slide, there also has been a change in the architecture of Microsoft Charge. Since release 1911, AutoSAR also provides a definition for a TLS extension to the TCP/IP module. To be as much in line with the official AutoSAR architecture as possible, we've decided to replace vTLS with the so-called TCP/IP option TLS for Microsoft Charge. Since TCP/IP option TLS utilizes the key M, short for key manager, to store and manage the root certificates, Microsoft Charge will also pass the certificate management on to the key M. Previously, this was done by the VSCC. This means that the key M is now the central place for the certificate management of Microsoft Charge and Microsoft Ethernet. Whether it's securely storing certificates in the VHSM, updating or deleting them, this is now all done through the key M. As promised, I will now get into more detail on the bidirectional power transfer as well as the dynamic mode. The main purpose of the bidirectional power transfer is to allow two use cases. One is balancing the grid, assisting with congestion management and frequency control. The other is allowing self-sufficient homes. Considering more and more renewable energies in the future, the grid is bound to become more unstable. To counter this, electric vehicles may be used as a buffer to avoid congestion and to ensure a stable frequency. When hundreds of thousands or even millions of electric vehicles are connected to the grid, they have a large enough impact that by charging or discharging, they can aid in the before-mentioned use cases. In some countries, natural disasters are more commonplace and often lead to homes getting disconnected from the grid. As modern EVs often have a battery size of 50 kilowatt hours or more, they may be used to supply the home while the grid connection is cut. Assuming an average family household, a single EV could supply it for a week or even longer. This leads us to the dynamic mode. Previously, it was always the EV's decision when it wanted to charge with how much power. When trying to support grid balancing or self-sufficient homes, this is of course not feasible. When a light is switched on, or the air condition needs to run, or food shall be cooked, the energy for that is needed immediately. Therefore, the charging station needs to command the EV to provide the requested amount of power as quickly as possible. This is what the dynamic mode is used for. The EV won't decide itself how much energy is transferred, but it's waiting for the command from the charging station. Finally, I want to give an outlook on what you can expect from Microsoft Charge in the future. Aside from the features of ISO 15118-20 that are already supported, we also plan to support the remaining features such as plug and charge, wireless power transfer, and automatic connection device pantograph. Compared to ISO 15118-2, plug and charge based on ISO 15118-20, improves the handling of multiple contract certificates. It's now possible to negotiate the used contract certificate between the EV and the charging station without the need to restart the communication. If there is no agreement for one contract, it's possible to fall back to EIM. Wireless power transfer allows inductive charging via WLAN according to IEC 61980. Pantograph charging for buses is covered by automatic connection device pantograph. As the name suggests, future revisions of ISO 15118-20 may introduce new automatic connection devices that, for example, connect to the underbody of a passenger car. As this presentation was mainly about Microsoft Charge for CCS, I also want to mention some news of Microsoft Charge for CAN. We currently already support CHAdeMO and GBT 27930 and are committed to fully support the next generation, CHAOGI. With CHAdeMO version 3, we are already able to provide the high-level communication protocol for CHAOGI-2. A new version of GBT 27930 for CHAOGI-1 hasn't been released yet, but a release is expected next year. Once the standard is available, of course, we will also support it with Microsoft Charge. This video was giving an overview about the new features that can be expected for Microsoft Charge with Microsoft 4 release 27, and an outlook on what to expect in future releases. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. Goodbye and see you soon in one of our next videos.